Welcome back, guys. We are in the chapter 2 where we are going to look into some lookup functions today. Whenever we are working in Excel and we want to populate the values in one data set by looking at the values in another sheet or a different data set on the same sheet itself, we come across and use certain functions called as the lookup functions. When you're looking at this data in generally, we can see that we have a column where we have certain salaries populated. Just by looking at the data, you will be able to understand that there is a reference table given on the right side, and based on the reference table, we want to calculate the tax rate in this particular column. If you have already done the if conditions can be used to somewhat get nearby what you actually want. You can actually look at the data and see that the number of conditions that you might want to create will be quite large. So in that case, the if conditions are not suitable, and the only option remains to use certain functions called as the lookup functions. So we have already used the VLOOKUP formula in the earlier videos, where we use the VLOOKUP in a student database management system. I'll be putting up the link for that particular video as we speak, and you can refer that video and look at that function being used over there. In the same manner, we are going to try and use the same VLOOKUP function over here with this kind of a data. Let's look at this data set now. We have something called as the employee name, the department, the hire date of the employees, the year, the salary, and we need to calculate the tax rate based on the tax table that is given on the right. Also, do remember, guys, the link to this video is kept on the description below, so you can access the sheet and practice it out over there as much as you can. Let's look at this data. We want to find where does the salary fall in this particular table. The salary 41,639 falls in the slab of 35,000 and 45,000 rupees. That means the salary falls in the range of 35,000 and 45,000 rupees. Hence, the name of the sheet we have given is approx match, because we are going to use VLOOKUP with approx match in this particular session. So let's try and see the formula first, and then try and speculate what is actually going on in the formula. So the formula begins with equals to VLOOKUP, bracket open. We are going to look for the salary, comma, in this particular data set. I have already given the name tax table to this data set. If you guys remember, in the earlier videos, we have already learned how to give a name to a range of cells. So I have selected this entire data, given it a name tax table, comma. We are going to look for the column number of the tax rate mentioned in the tax table. That means salary is the lookup column. That means salary is the column that is going to be looked up. That is the first column of my data set. And the lookup column where I want to find the tax rate is column number 2 in this table, comma, and approx match, that is true, bracket close, and enter. So there you go, guys. We have 6% which is allocated to the salary 41,639. That means the salary 41,639 falls in the slab of 35 and 45, and the tax rate allocated to it is 6%. So let's try and understand what is actually going on in the formula. We have looked up this particular salary, that is the salary 41,639, that is E2, comma, in the table, tax table, comma. The column that we need to print in this particular area is the column number 2 from this table, comma, and true for approximate match, because we are going to look for the data in ranges. There is no exact 41,639 in the tax table. There is no 56,469 in the tax table. There is no 43,302 in the tax table. But we know that each of them either lie in the range of 35 to 45 or 45 to 55 or any of the ranges below. Since we are going to look for the values from this table, but in ranges in this table, we are going to select approximate match, and for approximate match, we are going to select true, present. So once you have the data set and the formula in place, all you need to do is press the Control Shift and the down arrow key to select the entire column. That's the shortcut key for selecting the column. There are various shortcut keys that we'll be learning. First one is Control Shift and down arrow key, and then we are using Control D to populate the values from the respective data set that is over here. So Control D populates the values from the first cell, that's the formula, from the first cell to all the cells below. There you go. So we have done the first approx match data set one. I hope you guys have understood, and if you have any queries, you can ask me in the comment section below. I'll be also responding back by creating some new videos to your queries if required. Now let's go and look at the approx match data set 2. So we have quite an interesting set of data here. Again, we have to look at the salary column again to find out the tax rate that is applicable to the salary. Again, we have to look at the VLOOKUP formula itself. However, the formula is a little bit tricky right here, because along with the salary, we have another column called as the dependent. The dependent, which is mentioned over here, are the dependents which are also mentioned on the top in the reference table. This reference table is specifically a multi-dimensional table wherein we have the column of salaries, that is the slabs of different salaries mentioned on the left column, and the top column are the list of all your dependents. And whenever we want to look out for the tax rate, we have to look at both the columns and thereby calculate the tax rate based on it. So in this formula, we are going to look for 56,696, which lies in the slab of 55 and 60, if I'm right. And we are going to look for the dependent number 2, that is, we are going to look for dependent number 2 in this column, which gives me the tax salary to be approximately something like 10.9% for the first salary. So without wasting any time, let's try and do the formula, and we'll try and understand how to do this and how to get our value in a very interesting way. So we'll also learn something over here, is just not to directly get inside and try and create a formula that matches what you already know, but actually take your time to read the data, learn any patterns in the data, and also understand how the data is talking to you. So in this case, let's start with the formula VLOOKUP. VLOOKUP is going to tell me to look into the salary 56,696, comma. Again, for your convenience, I have given the name for the data. If no names pops up, select the entire data set. You can look for the name, or if no names are given specifically, you may just select the entire data set, select the entire data or the column names over here, and lock it by using the F4 function key. The function key helps you to lock the reference data. In this case, I have not given any name to your reference table, so you will need to select the entire table and give it an F4 function key so that you lock the reference data. This locking is required because when we drag the formula down, the reference table shouldn't change, because B2 will become B3, B3 will become B4, B4 will become B5. However, the reference table shouldn't change, hence we need to lock the reference data. Once that is done, comma, now it's asking me for the column index number. This is the part which becomes a little tricky. So we want to look for 56,696, that is in this particular table, but in column number 2 over here. So let's try and see where the dependent number 2 lies in this table. The dependent number 2 lies in which column in this table? The dependent number 2 lies in the first, second, third, fourth column. So we have dependent number 2 lying in the fourth column of this table. So what I'm going to put is 4 in this case, comma. And since again we are going to look up in ranges, I'm going to use true for approx match, close my brackets and enter. There you go, I have my answer, that is 10.9%. Let's try and drag this formula a little bit for some of the data. So let's look at the second value. We are going to look at 46,681. 46,681 lies in the range of 45 and 50. And I would look in the dependent column number 4. My dependent column number 4 is over here. So I want to look actually in this particular column. And what is the answer I am expecting? Is around 5.3%. However, the answer I have received is 8.30%. The reason being, I am still looking at the column which is actually pointing to 8.3%, that is the column number 4, which is going to be common for all the data. So in this case, the VLOOKUP formula fails to actually try and directly get into the column unless you specify the column number correctly. So let's try and find a relation between the dependent column, that is the column number C, and the dependent columns over here. So let's try and see. The dependent number 2 in this column lies in the fourth column in my reference table. The dependent number 4 in this column lies in the 6th column of my reference table. The dependent number 1 lies in the 3rd column of my reference table. Dependent number 3 lies in the 5th column of my reference table. The pattern is always plus 2. So whenever I want a value and get a pattern of dependent and the pattern with respect to the column referred by the dependent, it is always the dependent value plus 2. Hence, instead of putting 4 directly over here, we can use this VLOOKUP formula. And in the VLOOKUP formula, instead of putting the column number as 4, we are going to use the dependent column which is already given plus 2 to match the column number in our reference table and press enter. There you go, we have the formula in place. And once again, all we have to do is drag it down and there you go, we have the formula exactly the way we want it. So this is VLOOKUP with little bit of manipulation of the data. Hope you guys have understood. If any queries you have, if at all any queries you have, you may get back to me in the comment section so that I may respond to you in future videos. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. I hope you have understood and have liked the content that I have given in this particular video. We'll also be doing the exact match and the nested VLOOKUP examples in the coming videos. Don't forget to like and subscribe and leave your valuable feedback. At the same time, also remember to press the bell icon so that you get your proper notifications whenever a video is uploaded over the internet. And ciao guys. Take care. Stay home. Stay safe. I'm